Hello, investors. Patrick Walchuk here with an update on the multi-unit residential market to the end of August 2016. When we look at what's gone on for the first 8 months of this year with buildings that have 2 to 4 units in them, there were 82 sales compared to 75 last year, and that's an increase of about 9%. The average price of one of these buildings right now is about $625,000, and that's an increase of 8% over the first 8 months of last year. In terms of new listings in August, there were 36% fewer new listings, which is very interesting. There were 32 versus 50 compared to August of last year. Now, in terms of what sellers are getting when they sell these buildings, that's remained fairly consistent at 97% of their list price. That's called the list to sell price ratio. And this year, it's taking 66 days for one of these buildings to sell compared to 48 days last year. So when we take a look at the other segment of the market, as we do every month, and those are the buildings with 5 or more units in them, this has been a bit of an anomaly and it hasn't changed yet. So what I'm talking about is that we've had 12 sales only this year. And again, this is the 5+ unit category, 12 sales compared to 22 last year, which is a decrease of about 45-46%. The average price of these properties is about $1.1 million. And it was about $1.3 million last year. It's down about 14%. Now, I'm not reading a whole lot into that because the actual number of sales is so small, and quite frankly, I don't really understand why. Sellers have received 96% of their list price. These properties are taking longer to sell. They sell in 83 days compared to 75 last year. And about the only comment I can make on them is that I will see these buildings conditionally sold, and then they will appear back on the market 2, 3, 4 weeks later with the transaction having not been completed for a variety of reasons. Sometimes with these buildings it's financing, sometimes it's inspection, but to have a drop-off of almost 50% is quite unusual. So what I looked at is how many of these properties are on the market. So this year, in August, there were 38 of these buildings that were for sale. And when I look back historically in August of last year, for example, there were 33. August of the year before that, in 2014, there were 40. And before that, there were 26. So anyhow, you know, 26, 38, 40, that kind of thing. It just doesn't account for why the sales are down so much. I can only speculate that our housing stock is really getting quite old, a lot of deferred maintenance, and I'm finding that some buyers can be quite picky about that now, perhaps with good reason on some properties. Now, here's another point that I want to make, and that is that some of these properties, there's an expectation by sellers that they can get whatever price they want. And I was in a centrally located 4-unit building showing some clients of mine recently. The property was for sale for about $1 million, okay? A 4-unit building, $1 million. When you calculate the cap rate on that, it was 2.5%. A cap rate of 2.5%. Unbelievable. So no wonder that property's not selling, and some other properties as well. Now, with that property, just to extend that out, if you went in with a 35% down payment, so you take about $0.33 million of your hard-earned dollars, $0.33 million, you put that in as your down payment, you're going to be losing about $8,000 on that property every year. What kind of an investment's that? So, that's my rant. If you want more information about the multi-unit market, you can go to our website, agentinottawa.com. Just click on the multifamily tab, and there's information here for investors, articles about how to get started in investing, how to calculate the value of properties, financing, that kind of a thing. And when you scroll down on the multi-unit page, you'll get the listings for all across Ottawa and the outlying areas. And if you want to keep up to date with what's going on in the market, you can just click on our blog in the market updates. Thank you.